Joining me now is the Shadow Brexit Minister and Labour MP for Greenwich and Woolwich, Matthew Pennycook. Welcome to you. Indeed. Yeah. What's Labour's position? Do you support the Max FAC option of using technology to sort out the border issue, or do you support the idea of a customs partnership?
We support neither option in the sense that we've put forward a more credible, more practical alternative, which is a new and comprehensive EU-UK customs union. Neither of the two options that the Brexit subcommittee are debating today is, as you've just said to your previous guest, in any way credible. The first is untried and unproven, has been written off by the EU, not least because it would require all EU member states to rewrite their own domestic customs arrangements. The second is unproven and relies on technology that is not up and running. Neither, crucially, will be ready at the point in which we leave. So I think, in a sense, the debate that the subcommittee are having today is nonsensical. The only option to ensure no new customs, rules of origin checks at the border, to protect our manufacturing base, to ensure no hard border in Northern Ireland, is a new comprehensive customs union.
The problem with that, according to many, is that if we stay in a customs union, we will not have honoured what people voted for in the referendum.
We could debate endlessly why people voted the way they did. I certainly, and campaigned rigorously across my constituency and others, never heard anyone mention the customs union in any way. We would be leaving the EU, and as a country that is not a member state, would be negotiating a new comprehensive customs.
And you believe that's on offer? Because this has always been the problem, that if we do have a customs union, suggestions is that the European Union will say, look, you're in our trading bloc, you can't pursue your own ends.
Well, we think we go to Brussels, the team and Sir Keir Starmer, very often. We think it is a conversation that the EU would want to have. In fact, we think it'd open up a number of other more fruitful conversations if that was the position that the UK government were taking. And it crucially means, I mean, this idea that we can't trade, that we have not been trading and increasing our trade with the rest of the world as an EU member state is wrong. Trade, for example, Germany's trade with China far surpasses our own. They've done that within the EU. We would still, in a new comprehensive customs union, be able to strike trade agreements in those areas outside goods, services, intellectual property, data.
I mean, Germany's deal with China, for example, is within the remit of the European Union.
Yeah, and we would look, and we think that a new customs union would help do that, to replicate or reproduce those existing free trade agreements we're in. We want to be part of those trade agreements and new ones, but we think it's better to work with the EU to strike those, to be on the same side of the table, have a voice, have an influence in future deals, not be a passive recipient, but that is the way that we think that is what is in the national interest, because the idea that new free trade agreements outside a customs union can in any way make up for what we've got is for the birds.
I mean, in truth, whatever the cabinet subcommittee or the government's agreed position is, Labour's going to oppose it, isn't it, in the House of Commons?
Well, we think both options are unworkable. And what I find particularly staggering is that we've got less than 6 months until we have to agree the draft withdrawal agreement. There are two EU summits left, and only today are the cabinet discussing, not coming to a decision necessarily, discussing customs arrangements and what the UK government's position is. I think that's frankly incredible, an incredible situation to be in at this stage in the negotiation process. And it's because the government have absolutely no idea what their solution on customs or the Irish border is.
What's Labour going to do when these various amendments the Lords have been putting up come back to the Commons? What are you going to do?
Well, we need all of the Brexit legislation to come back to the Commons, the Customs Bill, the Trade Bill and the EU Withdrawal Bill, because these things need to be tested in the House of Commons. We think there is a sensible majority in the House of Commons for some of these options. On the specific point, if you're talking about the meaningful vote,
sure,
that needs to be tested. Cross-party amendment passed in the Lords. We've always said we've not called for a second referendum, but Parliament needs to have a role.
So you would support a meaningful vote?
We do amendment. Need a meaningful vote. Yeah. Now, absolutely. And it can't be an up-down, take-it-or-leave-it vote.
If that happens, do you think there is any way, given the fact that it's a minority government with support from the DUP, given the splits in the Conservative Party, do you think there's any way the government can actually get through a deal through the Houses of Commons?
I mean, I think no one at this stage knows what the parliamentary arithmetic would be if the cross-party amendment that the Lords passed on Monday is brought back to the Commons. We hope, I certainly hope, there is a majority for it. It would be the sensible option. It would be in the national interest. That's what needs to be tested. And what I fear might happen, though, is the government tries to delay this legislation, delay the Commons having a say on that. It needs to, we do need a meaningful vote. We were promised a meaningful vote. That can't be a Hobson's choice of take it or leave it. Parliament, if it decides the deal is not in the national interest, that we may do better, needs to be able to grip the situation and give the government some direction of what it wants to see next.
Mr. Pennycook, thank you very much indeed.